creating this club for a few reasons. First off, fishing is truly a passion of mine, and creating this club helps students find another hobby that they enjoy. This allows students to join a club that gives them a challenge both mentally and physically, and it gives the students an opportunity to learn about fish and nature outside of the classroom in more of a hands-on approach. So it's not just looking at textbooks and watching videos, but it's more getting up close and physical and doing all that kind of stuff. So, next slide, please. This club is a want, but it's also a need. Students of this club would love to have a club like this take place. To find out how popular this club would be, I asked 50 boys and 50 girls between freshman and junior class at random, and the results are pretty amazing if you take a look. 47 out of 50 boys said that they'd be interested in joining the club. That's 94%. And then 45 out of 50 girls said that they'd be interested in joining the club. That's 90%. And I was very surprised at that number with the amount of girls that want to join the club. But when you have these kinds of numbers, you can't look at clubs and organizations as wants. This club needs to be the next big thing at this school. Timelines and resources. To make this club happen, there are certain resources and events that need to happen here within the next few months. I need to get a teacher willing to act as a sponsor for my club. This teacher would organize the club, but it'd be very student-ran. The students would run all the meetings and events that would occur. Fundraisers will need to take place before this summer. This will allow the club to have money and expenses for when it starts up in the summer, or in the spring of 2017. And then I need to meet with lake owners and certain companies to make sure they'd be okay for a group of students to go fishing on certain bodies of water, whether it's lakes or ponds like Guy's Reservoir or Moore's Reservoir. And I know there's many neighborhoods around here that have great ponds that kids would be able to go fish on, so I just need to get permission to make sure that'd be okay. Next slide. And then my overall goal for this fishing club is that it gets approved by school principals and is an active club by the spring of 2017. As much as I'd love for it to be active here in the next few months, just for what I'm trying to get done, it's not really realistic for it to be done, so I'm going to need more time, and then spring of 2017 is when it'll take place. And then students will find a way to learn more about fishing and nature in a way that they can never do in the classroom, like I said before. Just more physically hands-on, not looking at textbooks, videos, being up close, learning how to fish, seeing how fish interact in water, and all that sorts of stuff. And then basically, I just want this club to be a big hit. I want schools around here and in the Midwest to look at us and go, wow, that's really cool. Like, we got to have that at this high school. So I just want it to be, I want us to be more like role models and start a new big thing. So.
Fishing. I don't enjoy cars at all. I enjoy fishing. I think it's a really neat thing. And there's nothing better than spending an afternoon on a boat fishing, and whether you catch them or don't catch them. It's an actual action thing. I think it's a great thing. And your presentation looked great. I think when you slow down a little bit, you get nervous in a situation. I know Brock, since he's been younger, you're an athlete, this is easy compared to what you do in a football field.
Yeah.
You can think about it, but there's lots of resources out there, I'm sure. I know this, you may know this, I don't know. State of Illinois, fishing is a sport in the state of Illinois, mm-hmm. if you knew that or not.
Mm-hmm. Actually, I looked that up and saw this.
And there are also, many colleges have fishing teams. Mm-hmm. That are fully sponsored and have scholarships and all those different things. So it's an avenue that once this gets going, can really broaden to a lot of things that people don't really realize. So obviously you're aware of that, but I want to make that a point to you, but I thought it was great.
Thank you, appreciate that.
I am not surprised to hear you're an athlete. When you kind of walk up, you get great posture. You know, you just have the initial sense of this guy's kind of got your confidence. Along those lines, what you were saying off of your notes is exactly what Shane said on the screen. So chuck the notes, you know, and use the screen, because it's all there. You know it anyway.
Yeah.
Use the screen as prompters, and then let that natural persona, you know, kind of air of confidence that you have just come out. Because I don't think you really need those notes. Interesting, you always kind of say, next slide, please. You know, I suppose you could go two ways on that, whether that's good or bad. One way that's kind of good is it's kind of like you're in command of the thing and you're being authoritative and you're telling the person ready to go and you're in control of the charge, kind of like that. You clearly have a passion for it. I'd like to hear a quick little anecdote, you know, a story of why you're passionate about it and what you could share right now.
All right, well, my dad's always been a fisherman. My dad grew up a fisherman. So when I was real young, he, first thing we do, always went to the pond and go fishing. That was one of the first things my dad taught me. So it's kind of, I've kind of been grown into it, I guess. Kind of like some people are grown into Colts fans, I was grown into being a fisherman. So that's kind of how it always started. And I've learned from videos and just personal experience just how to do it. And it's, every year goes on, they get better and better at it. So.
And I thought the support you gave was great. And then I think that the fact that you kind of concluded with the wow factor, which kind of came full circle about your passion, and I want others to look up to it, but I thought that was effective.
Thank you.
No, I thought you had a great deal of confidence coming out of you, and your tone and how you said it was, you know, was right on the mind. What I liked about your structure of this is, here's what you wanted, here's why you wanted, here's why we needed, you know, and now I'm going to tell you what we're going to get there. Coming from the education side as teachers, that's what we do, you know, most days in the classroom, and I like that. You gave the reasons why, and that was right off the start. You know, my brother was on the fishing team at Purdue for a short while when he was there, and he absolutely just loved it. And now, could you, so I guess a couple of questions. That, number one, could you see this going to where you go to competitions and that type of stuff, if there were teams from around here?
Absolutely, because that's where kind of where I was talking about. I wanted to be a big hit on the schools to follow with us. So, I mean, if we get it going in other schools, maybe Carmel and Fishers and those, like, hey, we need to get this going too, that it could turn out to be competition-wise.
And my last question was, would there be any problems or issues that you might foresee with, let's say, liability or something with if you go out in boats or something? Would there be anything there that you might...
I mean, we'd probably have people and the students and parents sign waivers just saying that, you know, injury may be a concern. And, but with the fundraising part, I think one of the first things we'd buy is life jackets so that if anything would happen or if a kid would fall in the water, that they'd be okay. So just protective stuff and all of that sort.
Perfect. Nice
job. Thank you. For deep comments, you know, the picture on the opening slide, great visual. Clearly know the material, you have the passion, drop the notes, it's the way to make a good connection to the audience. Ironically, in keeping with the theme here, we were talking in the break about my favorite fishing story when I was, I was about 12 years old, went out with my father and uncle, and I actually caught a shark.
Oh, wow.
But no, it's a great activity for families and fathers and sons, fathers and daughters, mothers and daughters,
absolutely.
It would be a very neat thing to you know, be a part of kicking off here. So good luck.
Thank you, appreciate that.
I love this because I think this is great. My husband likes to fish, and we have two girls, and he's trying to teach the girls how to, you know, bait the fish and throw the line out and all that. So I think it's really cool. I liked how you used statistics and you polled the kids. You took a survey, and I think that was a good way to show support of a program, of an idea that you're wanting to start. And I like how everything was so succinct and just, you know, organized, and you had a problem and you have a solution, and I like how you organized all your material. I wanted to let you know that as a resource, Flat Fork Park, which is a new park here in Fishers, we have a stock pond that the DNR stocks it full of fish.
Oh, wow.
And so as I was thinking about this, I thought, well, maybe, you know, we could work again with the Parks and Recreation Department, maybe get some volunteers to initially maybe help to just start the club and volunteer their time to get the students going while you start to fundraise and things like that. So those are some ideas.
As a fisherman, where is that
part? it's a new one over by, what is, so it's like by over by, where is it? I get confused because I don't know. Cynthia Ann Road, where the Sledding Hill is.
Oh, so that's
the new Sledding Hill Park there, Flat Fork Park. Anyway, that's the park. It's really cool. So, yeah.
Oh, it's a great idea.
You got to play on Saturday now?
So, Mr. Peterson, do you want to be the
school pump? Yeah, my spirit.
I think you did a great job. I think this is an awesome idea. My son that just graduated last year, my husband had taken him to fishing occasionally, but he and his friends fished all summer, and he would tell me where they were fishing. It was mostly neighborhood ponds, and I'm like, are you sure you could be there? Oh yeah, we know somebody who was in that neighborhood, but, you know, just kids are going to find ways to do this, and I think, you know, having a sponsor, and, you know, let's talk about the rules, you have to have fishing license, you have to do this, I think that'd be a great way to do it. I think the fact that it's not electronically related, and it's, you know, disconnecting and being with nature, I think is wonderful, and that's exactly what, maybe not kids might want, but, you know, parents and the older generation, these kids nowadays don't know how to slow down, and I think this would be perfect, and I think you would probably have to limit the club, because I think it's a little older.
Yeah, absolutely.
And I don't know that you'll have a problem with sponsors for it, if you, it doesn't have to be a city club, basically.
One other quick thing, I love the first slide and the catchy title. It catches your attention, and you're just like, what's he talking about? It's really cool. So I love the intro and the topic, the title of this topic.
And
well,
I like the logo. Did you make that logo?
I did.
Yeah, that was very, very nice. And if you present that, I think you've obviously given it a spot.
Mm-hmm. Well, thank you. Appreciate that.